I am Maura Miri, Beth L's food educator, and I have 8 fun, easy treats so you can make something special every single night of Hanukkah.
Okay, first up, we have Hanukkah gelts in blondies. You can use brownie mix, you can get really ambitious and make thumbprint cookies, but just pop some Hanukkah gelt in there and bake them up, and you can kind of see those Hanukkah menorahs in there. But that's a really fun, easy way to just make a quick treat. Okay, now we have an edible Hanukkah or menorah. You can do this with absolutely anything you want. I sort of went with the cheese and fruit platter, sort of geared towards little ones, but you can make this really big for a platter or do a salad style thing. You can just chuck a bunch of food at your kids and give them something to do, and they can each make their own. If you've got a Hanukkah movie night planned, you can just pop some popcorn, air pop it, drizzle on some olive oil, because Hanukkah miracle, right? Whatever your favorite spice is, I happen to really like za'atar, you can do curry powder, pinch of salt if you want, and there you go. Rugrats Hanukkah special never gets old, so that's kind of a perfect snack. Now we've got edible dreidels. This is just a tortilla that I cut into a dreidel shape, and we made quesadillas. You can also use cookie cutters if you happen to have those. And with all of the leftover tortilla that I had, I just sort of freeform cut little dreidels and put these on a baking sheet, drizzle with olive oil, some spices, and pop them in the oven for maybe 3 to 5 minutes. They will get crunchy really fast, and you have little chips. Okay, if you're doing sort of a fancier dinner, you can make a little olive oil dipping sauce. I am just gonna add some oregano. You can do some garlic. Good crusty bread. If anyone's got some sourdough going, that would be perfect. Very simple way to celebrate the olive oil in the Hanukkah story. Here's something you can do both to keep people occupied or to do a little fun family contest over Zoom, possibly, or just at home with whoever's there. Latke, and this is a frozen latke, right? Give everyone some frozen latkes, give them some ingredients, whatever you happen to have on hand, any latke toppings you like. You can do little pictures. You can get really fancy, go Top Chef style, and give every, you know, just lay out a bunch of ingredients, let everyone go to town with toppings and vote on them. Parents, you can be the judges or you can be the contestants, however you want to do it. Another fun thing to do with leftover latkes is just put on some tomato sauce, some cheese, pop them in the oven, warm them up, you got little pizza latkes. This may be my favorite hack this year. I see a lot of recipes for sufganiyot that are a little complicated or probably don't cook all the way through, like if you're starting with pizza dough or something. It's not so easy to get those going the way you want. So in here, you can see there's some jam. This is bread, and I put some jam inside, pan-fried it in olive oil, dusted with powdered sugar. So I'll show you how to do that real fast. Okay, so I've got rounds of bread. I am going to take a little spoonful of jam. You don't want to do too much because you need it to sort of stay in there, right? Put another round right on top. Use a fork to crimp around the edges. Be careful that you don't want to like cut through the bread, but you want sort of a soft, squishy bread. You can also just kind of pinch the edges too to make sure they stay sealed. Then, well, imagine this is on the stove. You're gonna put some olive oil in. If you think the idea of like sweet and savory olive oil sounds strange, trust me, taste it. It's really great. You'll warm this up on pan fry it till it's really crispy. And when you're all done, just dust it with some powdered sugar. Obviously, this one's not cooked, but you get the idea. So I hope that gave you some good ideas for Hanukkah. If you've got any other food hacks or fun Hanukkah ideas, or if you try any of these and you want to take some pictures and send them our way, please do. Have a happy Hanukkah and stay safe.